Hi friends, how are you all? So we are taking up the second case study today, and before that some motivation for you. There are better starters than me, but I am a strong finisher. Okay, so that's what is the best one for you now, because already the September have come, October, November, December, and then your favorite January again have come back. Mostly the exam will be in and around second week of January. Okay, so don't expect like much of the delay in the exam. So whatever the things are there, anybody have started before you and all that, but you should finish it strongly. Okay, I am telling up that you should finish up this particular thing very strongly, and that's what the famous quote said by Usain Bolt, that is, there are better starters than me, but I am a strong finisher. And be that, guys. Okay? Don't linger upon the various things that this is there, that is there. Just start up and finish the race with a bang. Okay? Keep on working hard. So now coming back to the script typhus case study. So actually this is a real case which I've taken up from the Jipmer website. Okay? So basically, in this, there's a 35-year-old man that was a strong stone driller by occupation, presented to the outpatient clinic in the Department of Medicine, Jipmer, with a history of what fever, body aches and headache since last 15 days. Okay, there was no icterus and lymphadenopathy. But this is the thing which you have to catch out. Eschar is there, noted on the upper abdomen, and there's a figure also, I will show you that. Liver and spleen were palpable 2 cm below the costal margins. They were there. Except for a mild leukocytosis, all other blood counts were normal. RFT, LFT were normal. Okay, one immunochromatographic test was also done, and it was found to be positive for antibodies. To what? So basically, we are talking about scrub typhus. You know that. We already know that. Okay. So immunochromatographic blood test is a CAR test, and that is positive for antibodies against which particular fellow? Obviously, that is against the Aurantia susugamosi. Okay, Aurantia susugamosi, that is the causative organism which causes what? Which causes scrub typhus. Okay, and you already know the drug of choice for most of the rickettsial disease is what? Oral doxycycline. So that is also there. 100 milligram BD, it is being given up for 7 days, that particular one, and the fever subsided on day 3 of. Okay, now you see this characteristic picture of this, which can come in exam also, and this is courtesy those particular fellows who have put this case on that website. Okay, so basically this is the typical Eshka in this particular one. And guys, if you remember, like in fact, if you can see up, then there's an additional finding here in this particular case of Tina versicella. As such, no relation to this particular scrub typhus case, but this is additional finding in this particular one of Tina versicella in a scrub typhus patient. Okay. As you already know that the typical features of any rickettsial disease is what? Fever, rash and lymphadenopathy. Okay, same thing happens to be here. But just now you have seen up, what is absent, guys? Lymphadenopathy is not there in that. So it can also happen. So where to look out for in the question? That is a typical one. That is a feature. But 40 to 50% only they have lymphadenopathy and all. But this Eschar is the characteristic feature which you need to look out, and this is also seen up in this picture, and this is without edema. Okay, so black Eschar without edema is a typical of what? Scrub typhus. And what is drug of choice, guys? Drug of choice is toxic. Now talking about this Eschar stuff, that is this one. This always is good to talk about Eschar, and this particular one is typically painless and non-pruritic. Okay, which you have seen in that picture, that is typically painless and non-pruritic, does not have itching and all. Okay, and this is often rewarding. If you look out for this, then your diagnosis is mostly made in that particular one, that is the scrub typhus. Okay, besides this, you know that the other name of scrub typhus is also termed as chigurosis. Why it is known as? Because it is a larval stage of mite that feeds on humans, and that's why it is also termed as what? Chigurosis. Okay, And this was asked in AIIMS exam. The mites can maintain the organisms through what? Trans-ovarian transmission. They can maintain this through what? Trans-ovarian transmission means they can transfer up from the like parents to the offspring. It can be transferred up. That is termed as trans-ovarian transmission. That is there, and mites can do that. Okay, and it is also termed as chigurosis, scrub typhus. Besides this, you need to remember here only that there is a typical tetrad seen in this, which is termed as genotic tetrad. And what is the genotic tetrad? In that, you have mite, obviously chigger. Okay. Besides that, you have mice. So mite and mice, easy to remember. Then certain small vegetations, that is also termed as shrubs. Shrubs are like small bushy vegetations, shrub vegetations. Okay. And besides that, the wet season. This is a typical tetrad, genotic tetrad of this chigurosis or scrub typhus, which you are calling out. Okay, mite, mice, vegetations, and wet season. Okay, guys. So remember in this particular one that these particular mite, mice, and shrubs in wet season is a typical genotic tetrad which is being asked frequently in the exam. So remember this particular thing first. Other than that, if somebody asks you in the lab diagnosis which all tests you can do up, one you already know, that is the Weil Felix test, which is a heterophile agglutination test. And scrub typhus is typically OXK, strongly positive. Okay, so basically, you know, now this is a cross reactivity between protease antigens and rickettsial antibody, that is termed as Weil Felix test. So OXK, it is strongly positive. Other than that, you can go for indirect immunofluorescent testing, and it is considered as gold standard. Okay, it is considered as gold standard for diagnosis. Okay, and nowadays our favorite PCR is slowly replacing it. PCR for what? Obviously PCR for scrub typhus, which is being caused by what? Orincia tsutsugamasi. Fine. And what is the tsutsugamasi word? The tsutsugamasi word is a Japanese word. Remember this thing also. And card tests are also available, guys, but those card tests, they are not found to be so much useful, which we have talked about in the question also, in the case. Okay, and these all card tests, they are based on which principle, guys? This was a question in AIIMS and All India also. Immunochromatographic test. And what is this immunochromatographic test? All your pregnancy card tests, hepatitis, this particular HIPAA card. Okay, so these all are immunochromatographic based test. And basically what happens in this, that nitrocellulose membrane is there. And on the nitrocellulose membrane, these antigens, antibody, they move by bridge principle. Chromatography. That's why it is termed as what? Immunochromatographic test. Okay, or card test. These are rapid tests, and they are not so good here. Okay, and drug of choice, you already know, guys, and drug of choice is doxy. Okay, which is given up in the case only. The doxycycline is the drug of choice for this particular condition. So these all things are there regarding this rickettsial disease, that is actually classified under Orincia. And why it is so? Because it lacks the lipopolysaccharide which other rickettsia they are having of. Okay, the one thing, and some genetic changes are also there in that. That's why it has been classified separately. But as such, you remember, it's in the rickettsial family. Because of these two features, like nowadays they are saying that you should classify it into Orincia. Okay, and that is also coming under a broad spectrum of rickettsia. Okay, and drug of choice for this particular one is doxy.